Mother Woman supports and empowers mothers to create positive personal and social change for ourselves, our families, our communities, and the world. At Mother Woman, we listen to mothers through our free support groups. We provide training to professionals and lay leaders so that those of us who work with mothers can listen in ways that fully support them. And through our political arm, Moms Rising of the Pioneer Valley, we advocate for changes in policies so that mothers and our families can thrive. We know that listening is the beginning point. When we listen, a mother can speak her truth. She is able to share her story of motherhood, her joys, and her deep, often private struggles. When we listen, she no longer thinks, "I'm the only one." She begins to see that there is hope and remembers her own inherent resilience as a woman and a mother. We mothers will do anything we need to and can do to care for our families. Like our own mothers and grandmothers before us, we are courageous even in the face of immense obstacles. Mothers want to change the world, not just for ourselves, but for our children and grandchildren. And we at Mother Woman are working with others to achieve that change. We have trained hundreds of professionals from organizations like Safe Passage, Grace House, Walalu Somali Sisters, Empty Arms, the Prison Birth Project, Mothers of Color Awareness Initiative, ServiceNet, and Clinical and Support Options. And we have trained medical professionals from Bay State, Franklin, Mercy, and Holyoke Medical Centers, Dartmouth Hitchcock, and Cooley Dickinson Hospitals. We also have trained lay leaders who are bringing our Mother Woman support groups to the support group model to the grassroots, to parents who have lost children through military service, parents with children with special needs, lesbian mothers, Latina mothers, adoptive parents, and grandparents. The list goes on and the demand increases. Our support groups for women with postpartum emotional challenges are also growing. Just 4 years ago in our region, there were no support groups for a mother in postpartum crisis to go to. Today, there are 4 of these specialized Mother Woman groups on the 91 corridor. Regionally, our postpartum support work is moving deeper into Hampden County, west to Berkshire County, and east to Boston. Never again on our watch will mothers in our communities suffer alone, believing that the world or their children would be better off without them. Mother Woman's goal is to have postpartum support groups available for every 2,000 births nationally. We know it is necessary, and we believe we have a key role in making this a reality. And others believe we do too. Last month, we presented our Mother Woman support group model at the annual conference of Postpartum Support International. We were received with overwhelming enthusiasm. We have been invited to conduct a national training for leaders in the field, and internationally, we have been invited to bring our work to Israel, Guatemala, and Mexico. Our vision is that there will be Mother Woman groups everywhere there are mothers. In hospitals, libraries, schools, places of worship, family centers, living rooms, kitchens, so that all mothers, no matter what their circumstances or challenges, will have places to go for the genuine support and community they need to grow and fulfill their potential as women and mothers. We at Mother Woman have been listening to mothers for over 10 years. And because of that, we are compelled to advocate for social policies that are essential for mothers and their families to thrive. We have listened to mothers' stories about their experiences with job loss when they or their children are ill. And we continue to advocate on behalf of paid sick leave legislation in the state of Massachusetts. We have listened to mothers talk about the impact of poverty on their lives, and we advocated for the Federal Paycheck Fairness Act. We let Senator Brown know that we expect him to support the rights of women to earn an equal wage to their male counterparts. We have listened to mothers' experiences with postpartum depression. We shared them with our state representative, Ellen Story, and we were invited to help her draft legislation that supports education, training, and postpartum care for mothers. That legislation was signed into law this past August. Each mother has her own story. Together, we tell the story of motherhood in America, and the direction for change becomes clear. Together, we create an unstoppable force because none of us stands alone. We each stand on the shoulders of the mothers who came before us. I am very grateful to have my own mother, Rhoda Friedman, here with me today. What I most appreciate and admire about my mother is how she has stuck by me through thick and thin. When I was in the midst of my own postpartum crisis, she was there for me. She made the critical difference for me and my family. And isn't that what all of us want to do as mothers for our own children? I know that's what I want to do for my daughter, Halia. Today is her birthday. Today is the day that I not only celebrate her incredible three-year-old self, but today is the day I celebrate my birth as her mother. I want her to have what I want for all of us, that she will be heard when she speaks her own truths as a woman, and if she chooses, as a mother. MotherWoman is the place where we do this with each other and for each other. Mother Woman is the home where all mothers can speak our truths and make the changes we know are essential for ourselves, our children, and our world. Thank you.